Alright, E-Man here. I want to do an addendum, or maybe more like a part two, to the previous video. I've learned how to do always cast spells on wands, and I want to show people how to customize their loadouts, so you can have whichever potions you want, whichever wand you want. So first off, to get always cast on your wand, you're going to need a Lua script, or an LUA script. I've got one pre-made I'm going to put in the description. I'm not going to explain it too much, because LUA is not something I'm super strong at, and I don't want to teach people the wrong things. The only thing you need to know about in this one is all you have to change is this. These are the same spell names you would use in the normal wand casting spells. So all the names in the previous list would apply. So change Pebble to whichever spell you want it to be. Save that and close it. We're going to install that into the game now. First, go to your Noita directory. Go to Mods. Go to the Wand Template file. Data. Entities. Items. And here's our wand. What we're going to do is add mywandsetup.lua to the same directory as mywand.xml. Then we're going to open mywand.xml. This is the same file we used to mod the wands. What we're going to do is we're going to go all the way down. And right here is a commented out section called LUA component. These mean it's a comment, which means everything in green text you see right here is not being read by the game, just like down here. What we need to do is make this not a comment anymore. So we're going to erase this, we're going to erase this, and now the game will read this as actual code. What this section does is lets the wand use LUA scripts, which is what we need. So now all I have to do is plug in the directory. You need to go from the mods file. So we'll just go up to here, we'll click this so it becomes text. We're going to go to mods, and we're going to select everything back. Do copy, so you've got everything from mods over. Paste that right here in the quotes. Now you've got your directory that your my wand setup LUA is in. We just need to add that at the end. I'm going to change the forward slashes to backslashes or whatever they're called, just to make sure it works properly, since that's what they are up here. Now that we have that set up, go ahead and save the game. We'll go ahead and run the game. So here we are in game. We'll do tab. And you'll see that we're missing a slot and that we have always cast pebble. The reason it's missing a slot is because the always cast counts as a slot. So we'll go ahead and go add one more to that. Go into my wand XML. We'll go up to deck capacity. Change that to 4. Control F to save. Go back into the game. Escape. Mods. Restart. Now you'll see we have a proper wand. Now that we've got that working, let's look at the loadouts. Go back to your mods folder. Wand template, data, entities, and this time we're going to go into player XML. Now I made this note in the file I provided in the last video, so you should all have this if you got that file. What this means is if you scroll down all the way this way, we'll find some comments. There we go. This section right here is what sets up the player loadout. So as you see, we have our custom wand here, the default bomb wand here, and your default water bottle here. So what I've done is gone and dug out the original water bottle file. And so what I have over here is that water bottle file copied out from the directory that I'll make available in the description also. In the next video, I'll show you how to get these yourself. But for now, I'm just going to do it this way because it's easier. We're going to go ahead and modify this file. Open this up. So the easiest way to do this is hit Control F, type in material, equals, and search. Usually I think 3 times. And right here, that's all you have to change. Let's just say you want to start with a Midas bottle. You just type in Midas right here. Control save. We're done with this. Rename this. We're going to call it Potion Midas. If you don't know, Midas is one of the alchemical secrets in the game. We won't go into that right now. What we'll do is install this in the game. So we're going to our directory, mods, our mod. We can really put this anywhere. We could put this anywhere. What we'll go ahead and do is put it in entities also, items. We can just put it in here for now. So there's that. Now we'll need to know this directory. Go from Moz and go all the way over. Copy again. We're going to go back. Then we're going to go to player XML again. Find this section we talked about before, where the player loadout is. Name equals inventory quick is a good way to search it. We're going to add a new line to this. I'm going to paste this here for storage. Go up, copy this line, Control C, Control V to paste, go back down, Control X to cut, backspace, backspace, just to clean that up. We're going to go ahead and paste this here. You could probably start at just data, but I'm starting at mods to make sure it works for everyone. And at the very end, we're going to add potion underscore Midas dot XML. Again, we'll just change the slashes real quick. All right, Control S to save. Let's go into the game. So here we are in game. I'm going to make a new game just to avoid any conflicts. And there you go. We have a Midas flask. Pour this out. It does its thing. All right. I hope that was helpful. That's it for me today. Later. Try to talk like a human. L-A-U. L-A-U. Yeah.